Welcome or welcome back to my channel. My name is Dream, but I go by Dreaming Sims. In this episode, I decided to literally give y'all a movie because there are scenes left and right in this episode. But first, let me not get ahead of myself. Let me explain who will be staying with Willow. This is Forrest Downing, aka Willow's brother, and what he is doing is nothing new, y'all. He is a super adventurous guy who I would consider a daredevil. Like, he has literally climbed Mount Komorebi and jumped off cliffs. Although he's mastered fitness and mountains, he cannot keep a girl to save his life, and what he is doing is nothing new. Like, he's been doing this since Willow's lived in the city. Whenever he has girl problems, because he's a womanizer, he comes to Willow's place to stay, and it's never planned. But at least what is planned is this episode, and there is a lot that happens. So with that being said, hope y'all enjoy this video, and let's get started. I just want y'all to know and see how delulu this man is, her brother, Forrest. So we're just peacefully sleeping on a Saturday morning and he wants to literally wake us up at 4 a.m. to go to the gym. The gym. Like, I'm all about the productive routines, but not today. But you know what, since he's in town, we are gonna go to the gym with him and help cheer him up, I guess. So let's check Willow's needs. Right now, she is feeling hungry. We're gonna take another shower because I don't know if I said this in my last video, but fun fact about me is I like taking morning and night showers. If I'm delulu over that, I'm sorry in advance, but you just have to, like, you sweat at night and you need a refresher in the morning. But that's just me. That is totally me. Like, please ignore me. Okay, and then we're gonna brush our teeth, and she is literally on the brink of starving, so I'm kind of scared. We're gonna grab something quick because we don't got time for Willow to be doing all this extra. And when you go to the gym, you don't want to eat like a full-on meal before going, because sometimes you can cramp up. So, ooh, an acai bowl. That sounds really good. That's probably a full-on meal, but oh well. He also needs to get ready. So when she gets out of the shower, she's like, you know what, bro? You can use my shower, my only shower. And he's going to take one as well. Actually, he's just going to get dressed. Willow, put your clothes on. Listen, you could be doing that if your brother wasn't here, but I think this would be cute because afterwards they do plan on going to a cafe for breakfast, so she's just gonna eat a little meal for right now. He's gonna come down here and get his stretch on because he is just so pumped to be hanging out with his little sister. We'll have him drink an energy juice. Oh, he ready. Okay, and now we are gonna head to the gym. She already cleaned up her plate. And we're gonna head to the gym for our bro. He's absolutely crazy. But let's go. All right. So, it started raining. Oh, wait, now it's not. Okay, so we are at the gym. And we are gonna head upstairs. And I think Willow's gonna start on cardio. Cause, like I said, I like doing that. And they're gonna work out together. I think this is cute brother-sister bonding moment. Oh my gosh, you know what? This came though in perfect timing because I'm sure she wanna brawl her brother for taking her out at freaking 4 a.m. to do this, but it's fine. So she's on the treadmill working it out. Oh, and what is he doing? Okay, boxer. Yeah, these are totally functional in the gym. Oh, Sutton's here, her coworker. Talking to Sutton right now. I'm gonna get off the treadmill because I have a feeling is he training us? Okay. I'd much prefer. Oh, well, that's her husband right there. So, and he just fell in front of us. So awkward. Yeah, but we are going to not fight. We're just gonna say you inspire me to be better because she's like such a sweetheart at work. Forrest is gonna do some working out on the pull-up bar, and then I think we are gonna go ahead over here and purchase some dumbbells to do. I think we actually have dumbbells. Let's see. No, we don't. Oh, also, I want to hang this up in the house, but is it narcissistic to hang up a photo of yourself, like a painting of yourself? It's not like she painted it, you know? It was Tomas, so. Oh, well, we're gonna probably do it anyways. We're gonna get one dumbbell. Dang, 400 simoleons. Not it being 400 simoleons. And we are gonna do an inventory workout. And then let's see with, oh my gosh. I'm telling y'all, he crazy. Let somebody pop off on his sister. He gonna tear them up. Like, I can't even do one of these. Go off, like for real. Okay, and homegirl's doing her little workout over here. I'm hoping we're gaining skills because our fitness skill is not. Okay, that's not bad. That's not bad. Let's see, maybe our brother can like train us. Let's go over here and box or practice punching together. Yeah, let's practice. I know he just was over here, but that don't matter. Oh, he can mentor, finally. Yep, tell her. Look, Willow's imagining this to be Vincent or something. Or even Lewis Kim, she's like, that dude. Always trying to mess with my feelings. But after this, they are gonna go downstairs, take a shower, get ready, because they're gonna go out to breakfast and catch up with each other since it's been so long. They have made it to the bakery that they planned on having breakfast at. This bakery is by Sim Scrolls and can be found on the gallery. We're gonna cancel on this because as much as we wanna brawl him, this being up here is gonna get on my nerves. This bakery is so cute. We're gonna order for here a croissant, and I think that he's gonna, oh. Did homie just walk out? He said, I don't get paid enough for this. Okay, a new guy's coming in. Well, let's try again. We're gonna just have him come over here. We're gonna order a croissant. He's gonna order a scone. We're gonna sit outside because it is a nice morning. It is warm outside and sunny. And then they're just gonna talk and catch up with each other. I'm gonna have him eat his poor little scone because he was like, I could not grab it earlier. We're gonna, ooh, we can ask sibling about love life. I'm curious because you came over here, you're all sad about some girl. Honestly, I'd like to find love. Yeah, bro, you be out here doing the most. But it's okay, we'll give him a pep talk and give him some encouragement, even though we can't really talk. We have not had the best encounter with romance, to be honest. After catching up with her brother and listening to all his crazy adventures and love life, as much as she wants to tell him about the creepy message she's seen, she chooses not to share it with him as her family doesn't know the full story of what happened in the past. Instead, Willow is just sharing with him how life has been in this city and how working on the new art gallery has been such a big opportunity for her to advance in her career. And since the art gallery opening is tomorrow and he is in town, she would love for him to come and support her. And he's definitely down to support his sister. Oh shoot, and it looks like Autumn is here. Hey, let's introduce Autumn to our brother. This is Forrest. And she's like, and he's like, oh, hey, like, give a friendly introduction. Yeah, we're gonna give Autumn a hug because it's so nice to see our really good friend that we've made here. Aww. And it looks like Autumn is leaving now, but it was nice catching up with her. It looks like there's something to play, so let's challenge our brother to this game, because I know he'd be liking this stuff. If we win, then he's taking our photos outside, and we're taking good quality photos. But if we lose, then he gets to win, and we don't get our photos outside. He hates taking photos, by the way. He is not that kind of dude. He much rather enjoy the moment than take photos. He's all about that. But no, did he actually win? Come on. We have to win. I want some good photos because I don't know if y'all saw, but the view outside is gorgeous. So we haven't told Forrest, but we're definitely taking Lewis Kim on his offer tonight. Forrest just ended up coming over and did not let us know. So this is our time we're spending with him, but we do actually have planned to go out with Lewis Kim tonight. Strictly for business matters. Strictly. Totally. Business matters completely. We ended up losing, but he said we can take selfies together outside. Aww. Stop. All right, let's put a filter on it. Yeah, we ended up losing, but he did say from memories that we can take photos together because this is a cute moment. Like, stop. That's too bright though. That's giving very bright. But we're gonna take our photos. Now that they finished breakfast and hanging out at this cafe, she is going to give him a tour of Windenburg a bit, and then they're going to get him a suit for tomorrow night. But we are going to let them enjoy their time together and jump straight to Willow getting ready for tonight because she has a business client to meet. Okay, we have made it back and we are brushing our teeth and then going to switch right into our outfit. We should take a shower, guys. Clearly, I'm obsessed with taking showers. But yeah, we're gonna have her take a shower again because we were out with our brother exploring the city. We got a little sweaty. It was hot today. But I honestly can't wait for y'all to see her fit because, y'all, it is slaying. Actually, before we change into our outfit, let's get a face mask. So we're gonna get one. I'm gonna get one from here. And we're gonna go for the gold face mask. We're gonna just have a little self-care moment before we go out with our business client. Yeah, strictly business things, you know? Yeah, but I definitely can't wait for y'all to see her fit tonight for meeting her business client. Oh my gosh, her brother is definitely gonna be like, girl, what are you doing? Like, we know that this is not meeting for a business client. When he sees this outfit, he's gonna be like, yeah, no. We will see her fit after this scene. Thank you. They have arrived to the restaurant he owns in downtown Windenburg, and Willow is in for a surprise tonight. She is like, where are the hosts slash hostesses? I'm a bit confused. And he's definitely like, come on, let's just go sit down. I decided to make the restaurant private tonight for us to discuss in private. And she's like, wait, what? He owns this restaurant? So we're gonna have her steady sit right there, and then we're gonna have him actually go into the kitchen because he planned on making them a meal for tonight. Okay, so right now Willow is just sitting down and she is just like so in shock. She thought that they were just going to like a fancy restaurant. She's like looking around like, oh my gosh, this is such a nice restaurant. She did not know that he owned his own restaurant. She knew from when she was at his house. She knew he was a great cook. Like, she enjoyed eating his food, but like, she did not know that he owned his own restaurant in Windenburg. So yeah, I'm not gonna lie, I think she's a bit excited to try this food again and get to know him, strictly for business, of course. Y'all, look what he's making. That looked good. And he also ended up changing out of his jacket because ain't no way he was about to cook in that blazer, but this is looking really good, not gonna lie. She's like, something smells so good. I don't know. For him to be cooking and making all these meals, clearly it's a lot more than a business client relationship. Like, we already knew that though. Let's not be dumb here. Like, clearly they're on a date. Like, bye. He had to get Willow to come out with him somehow, you know? He finally finished making the food and look, he made some really good looking lamb chops. Like, I really want some. I don't eat lamb, but this is probably gonna make me convert. Yeah, they're definitely gonna start digging in. So let's, oh my gosh, stop. Is this a serving?
God.
I didn't realize that this was a like full on 10 meal course. They're just gonna have to grab a serving, and then I literally have to have them grab a serving and then sit down. Cause making him have to make two full course meals, but hey, it's fine. That looks a lot better. So they are eating right now, but I am going to just go into the mega interactions I have, and we're gonna just ask him a couple get to know questions. This is so stereotypical. Yeah, so tell me about yourself. Hopefully they don't eat it in like two bites so they can enjoy their meal and talk. Let's see. And then, oh my gosh, I swear, these Sims, they be finishing it so fast. Oh my gosh, she is definitely one to flirt with him so badly. But no, he got the music on and everything. Okay, and then we're going to ask him, yeah, what are your pet peeves? I'm rolling. Aside from food, you're my favorite. Let's not let the impulse thoughts run, Willow. But first I want to check in on her buffs. So it says scrumptious from eating food. What a great meal. This foodie approves. Okay, that's saying a lot, Luzkin, because she is so picky when it comes to food, but she does eat everything. She's feeling proper because she does still have that that one trait. And then getting to know each other. From getting to know each other, this sim is excited to get to know their new love interests. And they see potential for new romance with this sim and are enjoying spending time getting to know them better. Yeah, as you can see, their bar isn't that high because they only had a one night stand. So yeah, we're just gonna keep like getting to know him better. Lewis Kim shows signs of the sage personality archetype. They seek wisdom and focus on finding the truth in every situation. Their knowledge-seeking nature might cause them to think too much and not act enough. Interesting. Hear about what do you want? Yeah, we're not going to go into the relationship stuff because we're not fully trying to get to know him on that level yet. We honestly are still trying to be careful because from episode 3, when we learned that Anna has an obsession with him, we want to avoid this man's in that kind of way. But I don't know. Willow, every time, finds herself infatuated with him. And I don't know what it is. Like, even when she was, you know, with Vincent, she still deeply cares about Vincent. But she definitely feels really strongly for this dude, like, in ways that she cannot explain. Let's see, they're gonna talk about family. He's gonna probably just share a little bit about his family and his upbringing, where he came about, but he's actually not that much of a, he's not that kind of dude that is gonna full on share his history. We'll find out more about that in later episodes, but yeah, he's just saying how he did have like a humble upbringing, that kind of thing. And I think it's really cool because they can relate on the fact that they're both not originally from Windenburg, and how they both struggle to fit in with the people that live here. You know, they all come from very old money, wealthy status, whereas Lewis Kim worked his way up from scratch and did not receive any money from his parents. Yeah, what does he like to do for fun? Oh, he flirted with us. Are you Wi-Fi? Because I'm totally feeling a... Y'all. Not him doing the dad joke, like the dad pickup lines. Like, girl, why you responded to... Oh my gosh, they won't stop. Somehow you make time stop and fly at the same time. Guys, I'm not controlling this. No one should be this good with words. How do you do it? Oh... You light up the room? Y'all, they will not stop. Oh my lord. Okay. Clearly they feeling each other. It's escalating. Sometimes lines of work. This is one of those times. Is it just Willow or is it just getting hotter in here? Y'all. Oh. All right. It is getting hot in here, as Nelly would say. I mean, what did I expect? Like I told y'all, I'm telling you, like, she has been feeling this dude. You're funny, girl. Okay, we're not doing all that. Guys, not with the, I'm done with them. They won't stop. But yes, they are clearly having a good time, y'all. But he also did want to seriously discuss business plans. He really did like the work that is happening at the art gallery. The build came out very nice. He would love for Willa to just design his future restaurants that he has in mind as well, because he has one restaurant right now, but he would love to build more and franchise his restaurant out. And so this is really good for Willa. Like, not only is she, you know, having a nice date with a fine dine rich man, but she is also getting a lot of opportunities in her career that are definitely going to help her move up. The day has come and we have finally made it to the art gallery opening, and Tomas and Will are just expressing their excitement over this project finally being done. And I know y'all see Lewis Kim checking Willow out. Like, we're not blind. This is giving episode 2 vibes. Tell me why we're talking to Tomas, and why did I see all the way over here, y'all? Why is Autumn and Vincent hanging with Forrest? Oh, and hold on, pause. Look, while I was having this set all up, excuse me, Forrest thinks Autumn MacArthur is attractive. Oh my gosh, this is getting sticky. Not us going with her brother, now she about to be with ours. Ooh, this is messy. I really want to talk to Lewis, but I don't think that's a good idea. Anna's right there. And yeah, we'll just talk to her and see how she's been. We have not been at her place since that wacko tea party. We'll maybe just ask her about her day. I'm shocked she hasn't come over yet. But I guess snakes hide their colors very well. It's me sitting at the harp to talk to her. I wanted to go to the bar to get something to drink, but I feel like this would be really awkward to come over here, so maybe not. Never mind. You know what? Since everybody's talking and have a great time and we don't want to go to the bar, why don't we just come and view some of his paintings? Oh, it looks like this guy's viewing a painting too. Take in the fact that we really completed this project and now he has a whole art gallery, y'all. Like, it's crazy to think that this was just a construction site and a model plan that her and her team built, and now it came to life. Like, this is just crazy. I love how he did some bunnies, though. Love how we're looking at something abstract and then you just see this. See, while I'm viewing a painting, I cannot let Anna out of my sight because she is already up on Lewis Kim. And I'm telling y'all, she is flirting with him. I know it doesn't look like it, but she's doing the interactions from one of my mega mods and it doesn't always look like they're flirting, but she is. I saw them compliments, baby girl. She over here doing them daddy pickup lines like... The nerve. This girl is, she stay on that Lewis Kim. But you know what? We'll let her get away with it because no one knows what's going on between Lewis and Willow. Like, they have not told anybody about the dinner that they had last night. So yeah, we'll let her slide, whatever. Yo, look at the boss breaking out on the dance moves. Okay. He killing it though. Maybe we'll build up the courage and get a drink. It's been so long since we've talked to Vincent, but hey, let's just go for it. I don't know if he's even gonna be willing to talk to us anyways. Oh, here's Autumn. All right, wait, let's give Autumn a hug before we go to the bar. She's congratulating us for a success on this art gallery. I swear, they have the cutest little relationship ever. Why you always lying? We're also gonna talk to Lucy and just see how she's been. We're gonna compliment her outfit because her outfit is slaying. Like, look at the bow tie in the front. We're gonna go talk to Lucy. We're just kind of gonna talk and mingle with everybody here who are at the art gallery. Some look familiar, some don't, because some of them were actually from the masquerade ball from episode 2. I don't know why it's saying we don't know each other. Like, we definitely do. Okay, we were gonna go to the bar, but Willow ended up getting bombarded by everyone because they're congratulating her on her project. But I want to talk about these two ladies real quick. Funny story about this woman and this woman. You guys have definitely seen them around town. These ladies have an elite club in the town called Aged and Refined Betty's to spill tea about people in the town. And this lady here dresses in black to remind the town of her deceased husband that supposedly got eaten by the cow plant they owned. Okay, when I tell y'all, Vincent has been at the bar this whole time. He's been at the bar this whole time. I think homie is depressed or something from our relationship ending, because why? He really ain't mingling with nobody. Only the people that come up to the bar, but he has not left the bar one bit. Something is just going on that does not sit right. But yeah, I think Willow is having her moment right now. She is definitely radiating from all the attention that she's getting for this new project that came out. Okay, he finally got up from the bar, so we're gonna just take a drink and I don't know where we're going. Why aren't we surprised? Ivan. Of course Willow finds him attractive. So I think we're gonna head over here because we did not want to be near Vincent, that's for sure. And we're just gonna drink our drink. And hello, our brother has another attractiveness alert for Lucy. Oh my gosh. Forrest got an attractiveness alert for Lucy. I low-key could see that happening. I'm not gonna lie. Guys, let's help him out. We're gonna help him out. Maybe we'll do like a... Knowing him, he would do a cheerful introduction. I want to help him out on this one because what? And I want to see if Lucy thinks like good about him. Oh, okay. Let's see. Sentiments about Lucy. Admirable. I want to check this out. Oh, that's terrible. No. Okay. Ready? Let's dissect this. So they have bad compatibility, but she's perceived as extremely attractive. And Lucy's sentiments about him is fun to be around and funny. Okay, that's the first time somebody's thinking, you know, Forrest is funny because usually he's corny. But oh my gosh. I thought this was gonna like work out, but I don't know. The bad compatibility. Yeah. Why does literally he never has good shots with girls? Like his whole reason of being here at our house right now is because he didn't work out with the last girl he was with. My goodness, Forrest. This is embarrassing. Oh, I know. I'm low-key thinking we should talk to Vincent, but I don't know. She's definitely looking at him. Oh, Lewis Kim came over though. Let's be on the lookout for Willow. Y'all, see what I mean? See what I mean? She is always watching. Always. We have to look out for her because she is on top of anybody coming for Lewis Kim. As soon as this man comes over here, she is like watching Willow. Like, somebody please help. Someone call 911. Willow's definitely having a great time though. She loved drinking that nectar. She's finding people attractive like always. She is, but ooh, we gotta go to the bathroom. So let's head upstairs. I think the bathroom is upstairs. I hope she does not do this squatty potty all the way upstairs. Please, Willow. But after she's done going to the bathroom, she's gonna mingle a bit more, say her goodbyes, and then head home with her brother.
Thank you.
We have reached the end of this episode, and we are definitely getting closer to uncovering what happened to Willow's past, especially now that her ex has appeared. I know it has been a while since the first episode, but that was Willow's ex who cheated on her, but it's really strange for him to appear after all this time, and it is definitely getting clear to Willow now that someone or several others are behind this all. I plan on this series having around 10 to 12 episodes, so we are almost there, y'all. If you enjoyed this episode, don't forget to leave a thumbs up, and I will see you in the next one.